What's up, Internet? How you doing? Welcome to CTRL+ALT+TECH, the IT Pro Web Show. I'm your host, Jeff Gretler, and today we're going to be talking about the evolution of apps. We're going to be singing all your favorite app hits, from Apper's Delight to Mama Said App You Out. So stick around, and I was going to say something. So stick around so we can app it up, flip it, rub it down, and get to that answer to that age-old question of, ooh-wee, what's up with that? What's up with that? Next on CTRL+ALT+TECH. I am so happy I found the cheat code to Micah's super secret new bumper. That is awesome. That was up, up, down, down, left, right, B, A, start. Thank you, Micah, for unlocking that. So welcome back. We're going to be talking about the evolution of apps today, and we can't do that because I can't talk to myself because my doctor said I'm not allowed to do that anymore. So we rounded up some friends. Well, we got two returning champions, and we have an internet guardian who's been with us all week long to answer questions, and he's going to answer more questions right now. So let's start bringing him in. Batting first from the internationally renowned internet show, Eli the Computer Guy. Please welcome Eli the Computer Guy. What's up, dude?
Hey.
How you doing? Doing good?
Good, good.
Long
tired.
Week?
Long yes, week. Yes.
We're starting to put some electrolytes in our Kool-Aid.
Yes,
so
yes,
it'll
yes.
keep you refreshed and
need
keep
some
more
caffeine
going.
In there.
Yes,
I think,
yes.
Yeah.
There was caffeine in those breakfast tacos. I don't know if you knew that.
Yeah, okay.
So that's how we do it here. Keep things lively. So you ready to do this?
Ready to do
ready
this.
To do ready this. To do All this. Right, let's fill in those empty chairs. So our returning champion, he is the Warlock, Chip Gowan. What's up?
What's up for the horn?
What's up, dude?
What's up, Jeff? Nice to see you again.
Man? I love the Dharma shirt. Live together or die alone. True, truth, truth.
Never truer words were spoken.
Yes, yes.
Jack Shepard.
Why don't you remind the peeps where you came from in your IT world?
Senior system engineer and own computer repair business.
Yes, computer chip.
Computer chip.
Computer chip. See what he did there?
Yeah.
Boom. It's great. Cards were cool. So welcome.
Thank you.
Ready to rock this. All right. And batting cleanup. The man who's so fun, he was born in a ball pit in the hospital. Please welcome Sammy P. What's up, man?
No, I'm not a ball pit.
Air high five. What's up, Sammy P? Welcome back.
Third time.
Three-timer.
Yep.
Three-timer.
I'll have to catch up. There was a guy on here a couple weeks ago. I can't remember his name. Seven. So.
John's got to be seven.
Was it John?
It's got to be John.
All I heard was seven. I lost all. I've been on seven times.
Well, you got time. It's Q2.
Yeah. I was like, ugh.
So, remind the IT peeps
I'm a systems administrator for a company called McCullen Hine and a part-time system admin marketing person for OneLink Software.
Right.
So I work all the time.
All the time.
All the time.
All IT works all the time.
From
what
like
we do.
5:30 in the morning to midnight.
So. Midnight. And even before that, after.
No, I got to sleep. So those are my sleeping hours. Yeah. I cough in.
Fair.
Not really. No coughing.
Awesome. All right. And let's look around into the internet ether and see if there's somebody in our CTRL+ALT+TECH. Oh, he is back. He is the leader of the one-man Todd squad, Todd DeRocca. He's back.
Let's go. What's up? I'm Todd, and I'm back in the chat lounge. How are you guys doing today? Hope you guys are having a great day. As always, I'm going to be your go-to guy to get all of your questions over to the guys on the orange carpet. Several questions have already been pouring in, so keep them coming, as I am always happy to send them over. And of course, those who ask questions get entered in to win some cool prizes. And this week, of course, we have the good old Spiceworks plushies. Catch this. Oh, camera guy.
Oh,
one more. Three for three. Yes! Three for three. And the other piece that we're giving away is this Spiceworks water bottle. Ooh, and this is squishy. So yeah, I'm not going to throw this because it'll bust the camera. Anyways, that's going to be given out to today. So get those questions in. And also, if you have questions for Eli the Computer Guy, first off, welcome to his fan base. Welcome to the Spiceworks family, all of you guys. Questions for Eli, just go ahead and get those into the chat window. Or if you're watching somewhere else, tweet those in using CTRL+ALT+TECH as the hashtag. And we'll make sure to get them over to Eli and the guys in the orange carpet. So Jeff, that's all from me blabbing on. Back to you.
Well, welcome back, Todd.
Thank you very much.
Scotty Karate didn't do too much damage over there.
No, Scotty Karate did not.
He did not.
No. Thanks, Scott, for filling in. Appreciate that.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's good to have you back, right, Gus? So it's good to have Todd back.
Gus is... he's speechless.
It's so exciting, Jeffrey.
You don't
Tom's
really...
back.
It is.
It's not Tom, it's Todd.
Todd.
Whatever. Efficiency's already gone down, Jeffrey.
Efficiency's going down. Todd?
I don't.
You don't?
I doubt that.
You doubt it?
I have, yeah.
All right.
It's probably gone way up.
Sorry, Gus. Gus is a little depressed this week, but...
Gus, I think of the song Reunited when I think of you, now that I'm back.
Now that you're back.
Reunited. Okay,
whoa.
Anyways, back to you.
All right. Good singing. We'll end up singing. All right. Apps. The Appolution. It's here. We're already in the midst of it. I mean, there's app stores, play stores, download stores. So, I mean, before you had to get an app, it would come in the mail with 5 free hours, right? So that was the old delivery system.
Mine said 96. 96?
96
free hours.
96 free hours. With
I think I got 30 minutes.
You got 30 minutes?
Yeah.
So that being said, so did apps kill media? Is media... media's dead?
I argue it is. I mean, I know everybody thinks I'm an Apple fanboy at this point, but I got my... not going back. Anyways, but you know, one of my one of the vendors sent me this product, and it required drivers to be installed. It was funny, because I have this beautiful, incredibly expensive MacBook Pro, and they sent me a CD, and I'm like, how do I put this thing in there? And so I ended up having to like dig through my box of crap and find like my old USB
optical drive
to install it. And you realize, not until that point, when you're looking at a CD and you're really like, how do I do this?
You know,
that you realize how much it's downloaded and apped and all that.
Similar with the flight, it just all of a sudden it would just disappear and it was gone. Chip, you think that's...
I argue that it's situational based on... you know, whether consumer or what part of the consumer, or if it's an IT, but, you know, I play World of Warcraft, and I could buy the digital collectors, that thingy like that you did. I could buy the digital collector's edition, which comes with the pet and the mount, but I like to have that book. I like to have, even though I've never looked at one now that I think of it, I've never even opened it up. I think it's still in the shrink wrap. But I can, but I have the box sitting up there, and I can look up there and go, look, I've spent the most money that you can spend on World of Warcraft, and I can prove it. Look, see? You know, I don't
know.
So
you want your media.
But I don't know why I feel that way. I don't know if that's human flaw or what, but I mean, I like having it sit there, even though I've honestly never used it, except for the Lich King CD, because the music is really good. But
just music.
Other than that, but as far as IT, anytime I need a driver, or if I need software, if I need... honestly, to get something for help desk to install Office or whatever, I just go ahead and re-download the ISO. You know, I don't ever really have it sitting out there, unless it's a long release between. But then as soon as you know it updates, I get rid of that and I do it again. I don't order any physical media or anything.
No, it's done.
Except for one time when we had to reinstall Apple OS, I had to order the media from Apple because like you can't download it anywhere.
It's pulling teeth.
Yeah, it was really inconvenient.
Oh, I guess we have some kind of thing we can send this software to you that doesn't go
over
wires.
I think Apple also names theirs off animals that they test on.
Yes.
So there's like snow leopard. I feel bad for them.
Wow.
You got media? You still got media hanging in there?
Yeah, we've
you got the big binder, don't you? Holds 12
it's
CDs.
It's only a small 10
but you
binder.
Put in 14, it's sharing sleeves.
Yeah, I mean,
you
still use
burnt
media.
Copies.
I mean, there's some applications that I use to like wipe hard drives and stuff that I can't download. I have to have media on it.
Okay.
And so, you know, at the end of the day, I need to wipe that stuff, and I have to have a disk to run it off of. So
I mean, we're not even just talking about disk. I mean, you think eventually it's going to get rid of those flash drives too? I mean, everything wants to be compact, portable.
I don't think it'll ever go away. I think there will always be use case for it to have it. It might get smaller, more compact, but I think there's something about human nature. I mean, it's like paperback books. I mean, they're never going to go away. It's going to get, you know, the market is still going to get smaller and smaller, but there's something about being textile to hold it.
You need that physical reality to give you experience. It can't just be that virtual experience. So it can't be a subscription that it's there no matter where you need it. You just call it down. You need it.
But what if it's not there?
Good point. That's a really good point. What if it's not there?
What if that company that, you know, I bought that cool app from suddenly goes away and I no longer have it, you know? Where if I had it on a media in my wonderful binder, that...
But that could be argued, you know, you have vinyl.
I mean, look
tapes.
What happened you to Flappy Birds when it went away. I mean, it was like, wow, people were selling their phones because they had it for $800.
Right.
That's so dumb. If media is going to stick around, then it needs to be put on crystals like Superman.
Finally,
uses it,
thank you. Preaching to the choir. Yes. I want to crack the crystal skulls. It's a personal goal of mine. Find out what data is on there. We know data is on there. We know it.
Yes.
It's Mayan data.
Yeah.
Right?
Mayan, yeah, and it tells how they made Earth and came from a different planet.
It is true, though, right?
Yeah.
Noah's Ark is not the big Ark. It's just a little piece that has all this DNA from all these different animals on there.
Yeah. And it, figuratively speaking, and it didn't... there was no, like, flood. It was actual purge of a virus scanner thingy.
That's what it was.
And
it was,
and Noah's Ark
was
a malware
outbreak.
It was the excluded directory. Yeah.
That all makes sense. Well, speaking of all
no,
of that,
it
so, makes 100%. So, really, what is that all marketing term? Like, the term software, isn't app just software?
Absolutely. App was definitely a word that was, it's a buzzword. It was
buzzword.
Created so that consumers could refer to something that they could buy easily.
Shorter.
Yeah.
Shorter, more compact.
Nobody wants to say digital library or software collection. It's an app.
Right. So then.
I like my software collection. I like my software collection.
So then would you argue with an app, like for a business out there, what would you say is more important, Eli, to start off? Do you need a website, or do you need an app, or do you need both?
Oh, you need a website.
I mean,
I see so much of this where everybody's trying to create all these native apps, and then it costs them so much money. Like, if you create a website, it'll run on Windows or Mac or your iPad or anything. Whereas if you do native app, I mean, for the same price, you got to do an Android app and an iOS app and a BlackBerry app. And then the iOS app, as soon as they update, now you've got to go to iOS 7. I mean, you could have an HTML4 website up from 1995 and it's still usable.
There are a lot of HTML4. They're actually still running.
But that's the thing. But if you have like an iOS 6 developed app, now that they've switched over to iOS 7, you need to do that porting to upgrade it.
So you are the hamster in the wheel that you got to keep going where something that's a little more static to have something out. What is your, you have a website, right?
I have a website for my personal computer repair business. I think that's the most important. It tells people, you know, where you're located, how to contact you, what services you provide, which is, I mean, the most important thing about your business. I do not have an app, although I'm sure you can, I've seen things like $15, get your app, which basically is it automates a process, which basically just creates a shortcut to your mobile website. You know, I do have a mobile website.
You do have a mobile one, right?
Yeah, okay. It automatically detects the browser, and then it has like four links, like services, click here for the map, and click here to call. So,
I think if you do,
I would
have
argue that the website's more important, but I think an app is important too. It just depends on what your business is. If you're eBay, then obviously an app is probably very, 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 very important.
Right. But you covered your bases by having that mobile website.
Absolutely.
So that
absolutely,
is app-ish.
Yeah. It wasn't a question. You got to keep up with the trends, and you see that, you know, the portion of web users that are coming from mobile devices is increasing every single month. And I don't know if it's tilted past 50% yet or not. I haven't looked lately, but at one point it will. I mean, people are browsing the web from their phone more and more every day.
Right. I would ask Gus, but he's upset right now that Todd's back. We could have got those numbers for you, but he's a little upset, so it's okay. It's good to have Todd back. So let's go over to Todd and see what's going on in the CTRL+ALT+ lounge. Our chat host, Todd DeRocca.
Hello. Thank you, Jeff.
Yes.
I don't know why I'm singing it, but I should sing everything, right? Okay. Anyways, got a lot of questions coming in.
All right, good.
This one comes from in the Creative One 91. This is actually for Eli. Eli, do you think work folders in Server 2012 with its eventual iPad app will be able to replace Dropbox, et cetera?
Whoa.
I guess that's for the whole panel, too.
Oh, no, well.
I like that chuckle to Eli.
I've been getting so beat up for the last hour on this whole Apple thing. But anyways, I'll just dive into it more.
Go for it.
I think Microsoft had a wonderful thing with Active Directory. I think they sat on their laurels, and I think Microsoft's gonna lose it. So I think if Microsoft had kept up with the times, they would be the dominant player. I think they dropped the ball, and they're just gonna get mauled. And so
they talk about, they have Xbox 4 now.
Ooh, but I mean, like
Xbox 4.
You look at you, you look at
they
Google
PlayStation 1, guys.
I mean, you look at Google Drive. You get a terabyte of information for $10 a month. You don't have to worry about RAID. You don't have to worry about
that's
your data
exactly
center.
That's exactly what I was thinking. Exactly.
$10, done.
Dude,
right? Or
it's the day they released that, I was like, okay, I upgraded. I deleted my Dropbox. I was done. That was it.
Yeah. No first client day. Access licenses. No.
Nope.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
That is impressive.
Yeah.
That is really impressive to get all that. But it's weird to think that a new service like that would already be on the ropes. Yeah. By another new service, which just goes with the industry. It's just multiplying so fast that you have to, you can't rest on your laurels. If you're very successful, you sit on a lot of money, but you still have to kind of be on that bleeding edge to stay relevant. So, good question. Todders. Did I say Todders? I was going to say Todd. Is there any more questions? But it came out as Todders.
Yeah.
Todders.
Thanks, Jeff. Can just sense that's gonna stick somehow. All right, the next question comes from Paragraph. Paragraph asks, do you guys have any app policies enforced on company phones, and what kind of apps are you thinking about blocking, if any?
So welcome, Paragraph. That's a good question. Sammy.
We don't have any policies in place right now. because they bring what they want, we set up their email, and that's the last time we see the device. I would like to start thinking about that because I hear it's a big shift. It'll be a company shift, but we don't have any policies currently in place to.
Well, I mean, it's obviously this whole trend is in its infancy, so it's things are going to have to start. Apps somewhat seem somewhat secluded from your network to just the phone, but eventually something's going to happen where its tentacles do reach across. I mean, I think you got to find that way to segregate work versus personal on that device. Mm-hmm. How do you do that without seeing everything on the device?
Well, like Geico had that, or Progressive had that app that would, it would tie back to their system to pull your information to your phone. So,
right.
It's
tied to their network for sure, and then you're bringing it across your bandwidth. So it is still gobbling bandwidth. So
that's pretty, I'm say pretty scary. If someone gets to my phone, if I have my bank stuff on there that just ties right into my bank, they get my phone, and now they have all my bank information. They go, doot, 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 all right,
Or, an app to block. Do you want to block people from using their bank apps? Do you want that liability of them doing any kind of banking, and then something happens on your network that affects their personal bank account?
It's a scary territory.
You don't care.
As long as they're not doing something illegal or inappropriate, I really don't care. Or something that causes me more work. If they're downloading some stupid Flappy Bird 2 EXE, there's
Flappy
no EXE
Bird.
On a phone. But yeah. And it's like crashing their phone, and I have to sit there and set it back to factory and reset up their email and everything. I'm not gonna enjoy that or go forward with that. But it's we don't have any kind of mobile management. We just tell them, don't be stupid. Use common sense. You're adults,
Have more confidence, stupid.
Yeah. Shut up, you moron.
No, but the user experience is important. I mean, the technology for their personal experience is so fast. When they come to work, they still need to have that experience to be somewhat productive. Right?
I believe so.
I mean, it's just like before, like listening to music, did people bring music that wasn't on a Walkman? 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 Anything? No. So it was all always going. Damn it. All right, I'm going to leave it on that. Todd, you want to do one more question?
Yeah. Let me pull it up here real fast.
All right.
So actually, this came from a question from a user who couldn't unfortunately make it today, but we're gonna ask his question a little bit later. So this one has to do with, do you guys worry about security of the apps that you are using, and if an issue with the that was awful. Let me try that again, sorry. Do you worry about the security of the apps that you are using, and if an issue with the security of the app, how do you manage that? So what do you guys think about that?
It's kind of what we were just talking about.
Yeah. Similar to what we were just talking about. Yeah, you do have to, like you were saying, where so you're running an app that's on your network. Where are those tentacles going? Is it going on your network? What data is it sniffing around on? So I think you do, if you're not, you do have to be a little bit concerned. So, I mean, that's why BYOD, MDM, it's huge right now. Yeah, I don't know if you want to speak on it a little.
Well, that's why I'm glad I'm now a YouTube personality and not these people, so I don't have to deal with this horse crap right now. Well, no, because, like, you know, when I had clients, a lot of my clients were these higher level companies, and what a lot of people aren't thinking about is their most valuable asset was their Rolodexes. Like, I had these clients, and nobody would think about it, but they did the roll on trash cans or whatever, you know, when they come out and they pick up your trash can. Apparently, right. That is a brutally cutthroat business. I mean, just viciously cutthroat, at least in Baltimore. And so my worry would be like, okay, BYOD, you bring your phone. I then import the entire company Rolodex onto my phone. I then install Flappy Bird or something that then just basically grabs all of that information and then exports it. And that's literally within 45 seconds, you can give to the world literally the most valuable asset in your company.
Wow, that's a good point. Suck!
I would argue as far as you say the tentacles getting out there from the app, but if that's why you use Active Directory. If you have permissions set right, you have firewalls set right on a server basis, they're not going to get anything. Most phones don't operate via Active Directory to begin with, so they're going to go in as everyone, and hopefully you don't have a bunch of folders out there, shares set to everyone. So that when they open up Flappy Bird, it's not flapping into your user accounts data. And your datas.
See what you did there? Get the bird sniffing around the data. Good stuff. Good questions. Keep your questions flapping in. I tried to do what Chip did. It didn't work. It worked when you did it. All right.
No, it worked. Totally worked.
It totally worked.
Yeah, yeah. You had it, dude. You nailed it.
All right. Eli, we had a great week here in Austin. Yeah. So people are always asking you questions. They ask us questions. So we decided to turn the tables a little bit and take Eli and show him where we go when we have questions. And now we're asking the questions, and we're going to go get the answers. But we're going to take it to the streets, and we're a little efficient. Yeah. We were on wheels when we did it because this was an IT ambush, the Segway edition.
We're back! Hey, Eli, I think it's time for an IT...
ambush!
That's right, let's do this. First question, ET or IT?
ET.
ET, dude.
ET.
Phone home?
I'll definitely go with ET.
IT or ET?
ET.
I've been on here 5 minutes and I miss my feet.
Which is worse, Angry Birds or Angry Nerds?
Nerds are bad.
Like Angry Birds like in a tree, like grackles?
Which is worse?
You know what nerds are, angry nerds are?
People that work for technology companies that didn't get stock options.
Speaking of segues, here's our next question.
What do you miss most about rotary phones?
Nothing.
Okay, now that there's a big push to be wearing technology, do you think smart pants are ever gonna catch on?
If they can't get the smart from my pants, then they don't need it.
Candy Crush Saga or Sonic for Sega?
Sonic for Sega.
Candy Crush Saga or Sonic for Sega?
I like girls.
Flappy Bird, Angry Bird, Big Bird, or Larry Bird? Games?
I would have to say Larry Bird.
Big Bird.
Well, what kind of device do you have?
Android.
Can you tell me your password? Do you capitalize the F?
What app on your phone are you most ashamed of?
Snapchat.
I don't know. I'm too embarrassed. I'm not going to say.
I don't know. What do you mean you're not going to say?
Locate My Panties app.
Wi-Fi or why bother?
Wi-Fi.
I need the Wi-Fi.
Wi-Fi?
I'm not an anti-Wi-Fi guy, but I think it should be like you should get 3 times connected to the internet a day.
Windows 8 or Windows 8?
Windows 8!
Windows 8!
Yay!
Now Windows 8.
What's your favorite mobile device, a pager or a Walkman?
Walkman.
I definitely have to go with the Walkman. Well, I don't know. Like, if I was a drug dealer, which I'm not.
Is too much software in your pocket a sign of low T?
Yes.
Is it easy to find a phone booth when your beeper app goes off?
I don't know what that is.
Phone booth?
Smartwatch or Baywatch?
Baywatch.
I'm just not a Dick Tracy kind of guy, so I'd go with Baywatch.
Watch this segue. That's what I did there.
What eats up more power on your mobile device, watching dirty videos or making your own?
Making them.
iPad Air or I don't care?
I don't care. I don't care.
Is that not? That is not the best way to get answers to questions, right?
Yeah, I'll go back to Baltimore, get my little Segway. Be like zipping down the road. Squid or samba?
And they're like, seafood allergy. No. That was good, but your shins were a little tingly after that?
It wasn't the shins, it was the bottom of the feet.
Yeah.
Like, you're like, oh. Like, when you guys asked, I was like, yeah, this will be awesome. And then, like, at the end of it, you're like hobbling off the Segway.
Yeah, when you get off, it's just like, wow, you definitely have some kind of atrophy already setting in.
It's,
yeah, I saw Wally. There's no way I'm going to stick to wheels. I'm going to keep walking. Well, keep walking. So, good stuff. Thanks for joining us on that. So, Todd, how's things going over in the Control-Alt Lounge?
Well, they are awesome, as always. Duh. We have a lot of questions coming in here, and so I want to ask this question. It seems like a lot of people want this, are asking this. And so the question comes from iTrick. iTrick asks, regarding app developments, what are your thoughts on websites that make them for you? They've been popping up lately, but are they recommended? Now, Morgan7283 says his issue would be security. Who says that there won't create a back door that will allow some kind of data to return to them? So, guys in the orange carpet, what are your thoughts on somebody else building the app for you?
That's a good question.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I think the main problem, I had a fan ask this last week, actually. People don't realize how simple most of this software, you know, app creation software is. Like, like somebody was talking about, I read this article, and it was like, this guy creates a Flappy Bird clone in 3 hours. And you're like, wow. Well, then you read it, and he went and bought the clone code, that, modified it a tiny bit, and then uploaded it.
Modified the images in it?
Yeah, and then uploaded it to the app store. So there's an idea of, yeah, you can get a complicated app up in the app store in 3 hours, basically if somebody else spent 3 months writing it.
Doing it.
So,
wow.
Yeah.
Sammy, you guys deal in software, right?
Yeah.
So what do you think about outsourcing app development? Too risky? Squeeze worth the juice?
We don't know. We're exploring that actually right now.
Right.
We've built one, and I don't know, about a year or so ago, and it took like 4 months just to get up and running, you know, just to get the code where we could give it to Apple to be checked, you know? Mm-hmm. And so we've had, that was a learning process, and now it would be faster, but now it's kind of like, well, there's other people who already do it, who already have that experience, you know?
Right.
So we're kind of looking into that, yeah, to see. But we don't have any hard ideas or facts yet. So.
Numbers. So answer your question is to be continued, right? Because it is it's an ever-evolving thing. So good question, though. Todd.
Jeff. Jeff. What do you want?
What do you want?
Wow.
So good.
All right. So the next one comes from IT Steve. Oh, by the way, a lot of you are asking for a Segway giveaway. Don't have that. But here's the cool thing. If you know a sponsor, your favorite vendor, who you think should be sponsoring that, tell us, and we'll see if we can hunt them down.
All right.
Anyways.
How much do things cost?
I don't know. Let's
well,
break
we
one
paid
and find out.
Some insurance, but it was like, it was definitely four or six numbers in there. For what it would cost if
four
I would have crashed.
Okay. Oh,
if Jessica would have crashed into the car.
$1,000 or $100,000.
Yeah.
It's a big gap.
All right, anyways, a question here from IT Steve. Thanks for joining us, IT Steve. What is the best app for monitoring server uptime and that can alert you when it's down?
Whoa, them fighting words.
An app for that? Seems like that would actually be on the server and then
pushing it back, yeah.
CMD.
There's some new vendors that I've seen that are trying to have that whole app as the monitor to give you that whole mobile experience. You think it's going to catch on? I don't have any experience with any of them yet, but
I haven't had any experience with any yet just because we haven't come across the need, but honestly, who wouldn't like a widget on their home screen of, you know, network availability and server uptime, little pie chart with what percentage of your network is
right.
up.
That wouldn't scare the hell out of you. To have something like in your pocket that's directly talking to your servers.
No. Not directly talking to your servers. Your servers are talking to a central monitoring hub that reports to the app.
Yeah, maybe that.
So you have all your servers in your pocket by proxy. But that's a pretty cool thing to think about.
So
anyway.
There's a couple cloud monitoring companies out there. I mean, I bet they have an app already. You know, hey, buy this suite. You know, I mean, I don't know, but we.
Right. So you want your rack to have a Twitter feed, basically, just sending out like stuff.
But that would be so cool if my app was like tweeting me like.
Yeah, tweeting.
Throwback Thursday. This is when I had an i3.
Nice.
On the
nice.
Flip side of that, I mean, we were talking about that this last night though. Is that idea of constantly being aware of what's going on? You know, it's great and all to some point, but at some point we also have to have a disconnect from our
right
systems. And
I mean, everybody's
always
connected.
And if it's always tweeting me or whatever, you know, my gut reaction is, oh crap, let me fix that, you know?
Yeah.
And so,
it's hard. It's hard. Do you turn your phone off at night?
No.
Well, you're.
Yeah. You don't count.
I sleep like a baby.
I sleep like a baby.
You better get your personality. You know how hard it is.
Chip, you turn your phone off at night?
No, I can't. I'm on call 24/7.
That's it. There you go.
Even when I'm not on call, I'm on call because there's always a chance that not only a crap storm, but like a crap tsunami happens. And so, you know, one person can take care of a crap storm, but then a crap tsunami calls in like the whole team. So
right.
You just, I can't. I have not been able to turn off my phone at night for 12 years.
Wow. See,
I'm lucky.
It's hard out there for a pimp.
Yeah, it is. Dang it.
You know, there's my boss, right?
And so that's right. Know what I'm saying?
They call my boss, and luckily, from the next tier down, the support, I live farthest away, so I'll be like the last person called in if something happens.
Yeah, that's
so
tough.
So he'll call everybody else closer. Yeah. Than,
it is hard.
Than
it's
me,
hard.
But it's like, you know.
And that's not even talking about the user issues.
If I had an app to do that, you know, to respond to me and be like, oh, you know, I'd feel the need to hop on, take care of it. Right.
Yeah, it's
then
hard to ignore
there,
it. If you know it's waiting for you, it is. So, because like I said, it's not, you want to come in the morning and get right to that issue or work on our users who go wild. See, there's somewhat of a segue. I struggle. I kind of squeezed into that, like hopped on the bed and squeezed into that segue jeans. So, yes, because we know they go wild. So let's talk about a little bit about our users going wild. All right, users, they go wild. So, guys, we're throwing you beads, so show us the goods.
So we were just like 30 seconds ago talking about having an app and being always connected, right?
Right.
So about 2 weeks ago, a month ago now, I get this random text message on my phone saying everything's down.
Everything.
Just everything's down. This was Saturday at like 7 p.m. I'm home. I have three kids, so I respond back. I'm putting the kids to bed. Good luck, you know? First off, I'm like, who's this? But then, you know, so I get them in bed, I'm sitting there, and I'm texting. And it's a manager who texted me on my personal phone to say everything's down. And I was like, okay, let me go talk to it. And then like last, I guess Monday morning at 6:30, I roll out of bed. I have a text message waiting for me going, everything's down again. And I was like, it can wait till I get to work. And when I got to work, it was, you know.
Everything's down, it can wait till later.
Obviously.
You know, but I was like, you're using my text messages, and I don't mind, but it's like, if I was always connected, at 6:30 in the morning, that's my time. You know my hours are from 8 to 5, and, you know.
Send him a bill.
I should, but I won't.
Bill it.
Yeah. But I was like, I'm not, you know, I guess I'm in more of a night owl, because if it would have happened 6:30 at night, I probably would have taken care of it. 6:30 in the morning, I was like,
yeah,
they can wait.
Free coffee.
Yeah. You know, but I was just like, you have my number. It's not for to tell me what's wrong. You know what I'm saying?
The sky is falling. Don't text me that.
You know, we have channels for that. Go through those channels. It's not going to get any faster.
No, I agree.
And so it's kind of scary that my personal number, which I've kind of safeguarded, has now been given out.
Yes.
And they feel...
been IT violated.
The free... Yeah!
It happens, man.
I was like, ooh, hey.
It's a slippery slope.
You know, so
good,
if I had an app that... like they get, you know, send me alerts and stuff, you know, it'd be
fine. All right, Chip, what's your users going wild story?
I can't bring back any crazy ones right now, but I can bring back excessive storage use. Of course, you know, I've got a couple of Netgear Ready NAS, like 27 terabytes that we keep for file storage. And one time I noticed, not one time, we're running out of space, which is all the time.
That's constant.
And I got to looking, doing a file audit, and I'm looking through file names, I'm like, Star Wars Trip Episode. I'm looking.
And that was your file.
That's a long title.
The user's using, like, I don't know, something ridiculous, like 5 terabytes, and he's like, backed up like every movie he's ever had. How did you even fit 5 terabytes on your iPhone? Because he's like, I did an iPhone back. I'm like, what iPhone model did you get that has 5 terabytes? He's like, no, I backed it up. So what are you, like, going home and putting new and then coming to work and, like, backing it up again?
Made his own iCloud on
but
your
I'm
stuff.
Like, yeah, I'm like, what? And like, he, like, totally was, like, oblivious to it. He's like, what? I'm just, like, backing up my iPhone, dude. I'm like, 5 terabytes. He's like, yeah?
You always tell me to back up, so I'm backing up. I back up everything.
Exactly.
Now.
You told me to always back up stuff. God. Yeah, but that was, I mean, excessive storage for a user. And then, you know, of course, I got in there and noticed everybody had all kinds of stuff. There was even one user who will remain nameless that had stored inappropriate video of non-mentionable nature. Yeah, and I did the good thing and just sent him a personal email and said, there's a file on your personal drive that needs to disappear in the next hour or else. I didn't put what or else was.
Yeah,
maybe he thought I was going to
I think it's implied or else.
Was it gone in an hour?
It was gone. Yeah, it was gone within about 30 seconds. I don't think that user realized it was there.
That's awesome.
Oh, it's gone.
It was
it's
probably gone. One of those files that was like, let me put it there for a second. And then I'm going to delete it as soon as I'm done.
Yeah.
And never mind. We'll stop right there.
Stop there. All right. Yeah. Eli, your user base is a little different now because you're more fans commenting and watching because you're, you know, an IT personality that's out there.
Yeah,
so
you
have anything that they get, they put you on the spot? To get? How do they get wild?
Well, the only ones they get wild is I always tell everybody, I'm just a mushroom with a webcam. Like everybody thinks, what? Like, well, no, like people
one
think, like, I want to be...
You give extra lives.
People start licking me. What is that? No. Well, no, but, like everybody has this idea, like, I ever want to be, like, a media personality. It was more like I happen to be a geek, and I happen to find I was pretty good on camera, and so I just kept doing that. But it's not like if my YouTube business blew up, I'd go and be a CIO or something. I would not continue doing this if this particular venture died. But then, like, I've had I had one guy, and God bless him if he's watching. I'm not laughing at you, but, like, I did this little meetup this one time.
He is talking to you.
And I figured, you know, okay, so fans or people that want to get together to do stuff, we can start doing a meetup. And I had this guy come. And he was from New Jersey in Baltimore. I'm like, oh, so how long did it take you to drive here? And he was like, oh, about 3.5 hours. I was like, oh, wow, you have a client here? You have family? It's like, no. I was like, excuse me. He drove 7 hours just to meet me.
Wow.
And I was like, should I tap dance for you? I don't, like, I really, I was, I
did
like.
Did you give him an autograph?
No, he didn't. He was just very happy to sit there and meet me. It was
wow.
Like, I was just like. I didn't even know what to do with it. I was
that's
like,
some fandom.
Yeah.
That's what it is. Your personality. You're gone there. It's interesting that you're kind of a unique entity in that way that you kind of covered that. So let's talk more about it. Let's take the CTRL+ALT+TECH lounge and we'll blink our eyes and we'll make it into Eli the Computer Guy's Eli's Corner.
Okay.
Let's do it. Back. Hey, hey, hey. See? I just checked out. We're back. All right. See? As soon as you say I'm done, I'm done. I thought it was just like, it's your show, man. Awesome. All right. Eli's Corner. That's your show. Take control of your show here. I'm just your guest. So, How was your week at Spiceworks?
The week at Spiceworks has been good so far. You are a lot bigger. It's like funny for any of you guys that don't know, especially for me. I mean, you guys have been my sponsors for about a year, so I knew you're a pretty decent size. But I swear, when I came up to this building, I saw the little sign up on the upper right hand corner. I was like, oh, they must be up in that quarter of the building. Right. I didn't realize you guys. I was like, oh no, you have this building, and you're gonna outgrow it in a year, and you guys are really
It happens fast. When I first started, this was all just gutted. Yeah. We weren't even up here. It just looked like an upstairs basement, and now here it is. So, but I mean, is it kind of unique as far as like an IT company goes? Is it what you expected to run into as far as the culture and?
Well, no, since you guys are like Spiceworks and you're technical, you actually have far more non-technical people than I ever expected. I mean, it seems like your marketing staff is actually probably sounds like one of your biggest departments.
Right.
And I wouldn't have expected that. Like your IT staff's like 8 people.
Right.
And your marketing staff is like 60.
Yeah. So. There's a reason this is gray.
So I think that was like one thing looking at a company that provides technical services. You don't always realize how important everything other than the tech actually is.
Right.
And so you come here and it's like you've got an amazing crew here that's doing all of this. And like, I would have never thought of that.
Yeah, it's pretty bonkers. So it's still your show. So if you want to throw it to Todd for questions, I'll sit back and see if he has any Eli questions.
Todd, do you have any questions? I don't know.
So here's a question that, first off, it's, okay, the people love your courses, by the way, so they want to know if you're going to bring them back.
No.
And also, I think some of them are wondering, how'd you even get started with your YouTube channel, Eli? Why did you decide to do the tech and the YouTube?
I never did plan to do the YouTube channel. The original thing was, for all you guys going to college, here's a little depressing story for you. After I shut down my business as a consultant, I decided I was going to become like the super computer geek and go and get my master's degree and my PhD. And I was sitting in my master's degree program, and I was looking at the book, and I realized I didn't care about anything that was in the book. I realized the guy sitting beside me didn't care about anything in the book, and I realized the professor didn't care about any of us.
Oh, wow.
And I had just been an employee, like my employees. I had just been an employer of techs. And so I thought, well, this is going to be 4 years of a waste of time and money. So I thought, you know, being an entrepreneur guy, like, how could I make money off of this? And the thought was, what if I created streaming video courses? So talk about the things that we get paid for. Like I talk about, you know, running cable is simple. You can teach a high school dropout to do it, and he can become an expert at it. And it's foolish amounts of money, but it only takes you 3 to 4 hours to learn, and then a lifetime to master.
Right.
But
you're right.
Yeah, so I thought about that. So if you look at my original courses that they talk about, it was like things like network cabling, data recovery, tune-ups, like all of these things like we have to figure out on our own. And I figured, you know, once you've done it for 5 years, you can just sit down and write a little course and hand that off to the next guy versus having them spend 5 years to figure out all this stuff.
So, yeah. No, it's pretty, it's an amazing story. And, you're creeping up at 300,000 followers.
290.
Right, you're today. Creeping up there, man. It's pretty, it's impressive. So we're glad you got to spend the week with us and we made it comfortable. So let's morph back into CTRL+ALT+TECH and see how things are going for CTRL+ALT+TECH side, Todd, in the lounge.
Yes. All right, it's back in the lounge. Okay, anyways,
back
awkward.
In the lounge.
This one comes from Donut Destroyer.
Oh, yes.
Pretty cool name, dude.
I like it.
He goes, how do you guys feel about software companies that require you to keep a USB, quote unquote, key plugged into your machine to use their platform?
You like it? You got the thing?
No, I think it's cool. It shows responsibility and it's good with security. I assume he's talking about the key that you need to boot up your computer.
Right.
The name eludes me right now. What is that?
key fob?
Wait a minute, to boot up or to run the sock? Because I used to have clients, they had to plug in some kind of encryption
serial,
key.
We had to do serial
in order to use the software.
Oh, yeah.
So it would check that.
Oh, no, we don't use that, but we've used them to use the OS.
Could ask them to clarify.
But I like that. We need clarification on that.
Okay, I'll get clarification.
We'll get clarification
from it.
But we have a little surprise. I don't know if you know this or not, but after you went to sleep, after our day on meals, we never stopped. So we decided, let's get more answers to more questions. So this is part two of our IT ambush. This is the St. Paddy's Day edition.
Oh, hi, Jeff.
What's up, Andy? How you doing?
I'm doing real good. How are you?
Doing great.
Jeff, what is today?
Today is St. Patrick's Day.
Or otherwise known as St. Paddy's Day. Am I right, Jessica? Am I right?
Jessica.
Jeff, and St. Paddy's Day, that calls for something special. What does that call for?
That calls for...
Tell him, Jess.
IT ambush.
Yeah!
La 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 la. Okay, ready. What is proper application?
Of what?
Proper application? For what? I don't know.
On a scale of 1 to 10, Ike.
Like, you're trying to get hardware?
Exactly. Next question.
What is the proper application?
You suck at reading.
What is worse, angry birds or angry nerds?
Angry nerds.
Angry birds or angry nerds?
Angry birds.
Birds.
Nerds.
Probably angry nerds. I've seen Die Hard, like the second to most recent one. It was pretty terrible.
That was a very long answer to a very short question.
IT or ET?
ET.
Wait, which is better, which is worse?
IT or ET?
ET, come on, baby.
IT or ET? Oh my gosh, Jarrett.
IT, come on.
All right, that's our first IT of the night, IT pros. Candy Crush Saga or Sonic for Sega?
Sonic for Sega.
Sonic all the way.
Sonic, though. My man, that's my guy.
Spoken like a true nerd, folks.
Is too much software in your pocket a sign of low T?
It depends on kind of software you're talking about.
Survey says, ding, ding, ding.
Ding, 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 ding.
Correct.
Ding.
When is hardware considered too software?
I say.
Might be correct. Google that.
What do you miss most about rotary phones? 3, 2, 1, 10-second dance party.
What are your feelings on nuclear-powered phones?
What?
What are your feelings on nuclear-powered phones? Are they too gooey?
I don't care. I'm from America.
Hey, we're from the same place.
Well, I think nuclear power is a bad, you know, well.
Right now, this is what it looks like going down in flames, Jarrett.
You're trying to trick me.
Smartwatch or Baywatch?
Baywatch.
Baywatch.
Baywatch's amazing.
Wi-Fi or why bother?
Why bother?
Why can't I, like, get her number every once in a while?
And we are assisting with a pickup currently, Jeff.
Can you view a 3D printer without special glasses?
Absolutely. Yes. I can view anything without special glasses.
Do anything you want. What app on your phone are you most ashamed of?
Snapchat. Next question, Jeff. What size smart pants would you wear?
Small.
The correct answer was digital. What is the better Apple, Macintosh or Braeburn?
Macintosh?
What's Braeburn?
Software or firmware?
I don't even know what firmware is.
The hope of the nation is riding on the answer to this question, Case.
Google Glass or Google Pass?
Google. I have a college degree.
I never doubted it for a second, Ike. Liam, how many cups do you have in your hand right now?
15.
Do you know that for sure? No.
She's getting arrested. Let's see that. There you go.
Oh, she definitely is.
When does the price of 15?
Come on, baby. Kick them daisies. They're going to take nukes on. How do you feel about that one? How does that make you feel? Great.
Oh,
he's done that before.
Wait, what?
Correct.
Can you just tell one of these chicks that I'm a celebrity and help me out?
TV, woo! Woo!
Rock on, Spiceworks. You guys are awesome.
And ladies, did you have a great time doing an
ID ambush?
Wow, I don't remember most of that night, so thank you, Andy Schneider, for subbing in when I was not so good with the words, and he was there with a second mic, and he took over because it was a long day. It was a long day and it was a long night. So, but it was good. It was fun. So, because it's good to do something non-IT related every once in a while. Because sometimes we got a lot to do and we don't have a lot to do it with. So sometimes it gets a little crazy and we need to make stuff work with paperclips, so we go all Spice Guyver. A lot to do and not a lot to do it with. So we make stuff work, you know, and we're in IT, let's start with a computer chip for the Horde. How do you make it work with paper clips?
Well, you know, this one time, like, I had this SSD, and like, it was like throwing errors, and so I like, threw some bubble gum wrapper in it, and then it worked. I swear, what, do you call me a liar?
I'm not calling you a liar. We're sticking to it. That's your story, and you're sticking to it. It's a good one. Top that, Sammy.
Oh, nothing that cool, but we were talking about apps, so I brought my mobile new...
Yeah, what is that?
Link Sprinter 200 from Fluke. It's a Ethernet tester. And so the cool thing about it, besides being small, it sends an email to my phone with the results, so I could respond back and... make notes, so it helped me map my network a couple weeks ago. Nice. About a month ago, because we were doing a build out and we had a third party company run all the wires, and so I got to go test it afterwards and realize they put in a patch panel and not tell me about it. So I was like, it's not working! It's not working!
Hey man, you map your network with something in your pocket. That's,
I did.
That's
it was,
all you
it was
gotta
nice.
Do.
It was really, all right. Really cool.
Eli, you got something you can scrape up, even if it's from your users.
No, well, actually, it was from me.
From you, all right.
It was the government screwing with us again. I went on this vacation out in like West Virginia, and there's this place that in the modern world you would never think of. It's called like the National Silence Zone.
West Virginia, that's what it's called. West Virginia.
Well, no, but apparently there's this massive like radio telescope there, and so there's this huge, it's something like a 150 square mile area where there are no cell towers, there's
really?
No Wi-Fi, there's no, like all the stuff that's the modern world isn't there. And so I had my little GPS, my little Android phone. I was zipping down the highway, really happy all the way until it was like lost all signal, and so I had
no
like,
idea. That's
Yeah, had
crazy.
To had to pull over in this weird little gas station and go like, yeah, do you have any maps? And then I like pulled it out, I'm like, how do I use this thing? But yeah, no, the entire I had planned to do like telecommuting for like a week, and it was nice because it was just like, oh well, I can't.
You had to use a map. Damn, Dora.
It's much more like you think about maps, and you're like, it's no big deal. But like when you get used to GPS, like actually pulling out this map,
right.
Like while you're driving, you're like. Ooh,
trying to figure out where you are.
Yeah.
That's good though, man. Sometimes you gotta make it primitive. Good stuff. Todd, let's go over to the lounge. What do you want to do? You want a question? Do you want to clean up? What do you want to do?
I want to dig a question out.
Actually, this is a good kind of a question. This is for Eli, but I think the panel can chime in on here. So this guy,
is that his name?
Yeah. He says, so we keep hearing more and more with Windows 8 that Linux will take over in the corporate world for clients. Personally, I don't think so, because nothing offers the simplicity of AD group policy. But what do you guys think of that?
How many episodes of Eli the Computer Guy is it going to take to get users to understand Linux?
What happened over there?
Linux, well, it's... As I have said before, I think if Microsoft had kept up with the times, I think Active Directory would just stomp everybody.
Right.
But they have. I mean, look at all these mobile devices and everything, and they're not really doing a whole lot. So I think Linux will, I would argue, in the five-year time frame. I don't think right quite now.
Right.
But if you look at Chrome, I mean, who would have, like, when you think about Android 5 years ago, everybody, who the hell is going to use Android? And now 60% of the mobile device market is Android. You know, you look at Chromebook and everybody laughs at it. And again, you go out 2-3 years and...
No, yeah, yeah. It was very unexpected. I mean, the whole thing is just a browser.
Yeah. I mean, the fact that when... I mean, think about this. Microsoft is actually making Scroogle commercials about the Chromebook. How scared are they? This has like...
And none of the facts that they have in there are actually facts.
Yeah, and it's like the Chromebook.
You can't use it if it's not online. Yeah. Oh, really? Yeah, actually, you can.
Yeah. It's like Chromebook has 1% of the market, and yet they're scared enough of it to actually do an ad campaign. That doesn't look good for
that's,
Microsoft.
That's a good point, actually. That is a very good point.
Well, Tech Frontier-ish, it's going to be whatever that experience that's easy to use at home will eventually leak into the workplace. So whoever's dominant, and that's why BYOD happened, so that next version. So whatever can catch on at home, So the workforce that's coming up that they're used to having, that's what it's going to be. And I mean, I still think it's debatable, but everybody's in the mix now.
Yeah, but, I mean, even now, you know, we're pretty much a Linux backend shop, and all of our end users have Windows. And you know, but you can't buy a computer from Dell without getting Office on it, or you know, right. Microsoft mm-hmm. Windows. I mean, they used to have. You used to be able to get Linux on it, and now they have an exclusive contract with Microsoft, and I'm pretty sure other companies will end up going that route. And so, you know, I mean, if they're afraid of Google, they're afraid of, you know, they're building these contracts that you won't be able to purchase it, but so you'll have to, consumer-wise, you know, SIT-wise, we can go rip it out. Consumer-wise, they're just going to get whatever.
Right.
I'm going to take it off the shelf. It's going to have Windows on it. I'm going to have Windows.
Well, with that being said, you should point out that pretty much every manufacturer out there has a Chromebook or a Chrome OS version of their product. I can't think of one offhand that doesn't have, you know, a Chromebook. Maybe Lenovo.
Right.
I haven't seen a Lenovo Chromebook, but
it's going to be interesting. It's definitely up for grabs. So let's see where it goes. That's what makes this industry exciting. So great job, guys. It's a good show. We're going to throw it back over to the Control-Alt Lounge to our chat host Todd, and he's going to clean up for us.
Yep, clean up aisle 5. All right, guys, thanks so much for your questions. Thanks again for asking all those questions to Eli, and glad he's here this week with us and on the show today. So let's go ahead and get to the good part of who are our winners today. And so the winners are Donut Destroyer, that's for you. IT Steve, that's for you. Chris Boyd, that's for you. And the creative one, this is for you.
All right.
And you can choose. And so what you're going to do is go ahead and PM me in the community. And tell me your address, and also tell me which one you want. You can pick the Spice Rex or our cool new squishy water bottles. Anyway, that's all for me over at the Control-Alt-Tech Lounge. I'll see you next week. And Jeff, back to you guys on the orange carpet.
All right. Great show, guys. Thank you, Eli. The fun's going to continue us a little bit later. Thanks, Chip. Sammy, we'll definitely be seeing you guys again. And hopefully you guys had your phone in airplane mode. But don't forget to join us on April 4th. We're going to have a little... for our homies out there, for XP, breaking up with XP. We're gonna be a little bit of a relationship show. So that's on April 4th. So until then, Control-Alt-Tech yourself before you wreck yourself. I think stuff is happening here. Stuff seems to be happening because someone was not in airplane mode.
Does anyone else really miss Scott?
Stuff is happening.
Our sides are unequal.